I'm Joe Biden. I'm Jill's husband. That's how I'm known in this town. I want to get a couple things straight at the outset here. I see so many familiar faces. Number one, when she said all of us of Hispanic or Irish or Italian heritage, she doesn't think they're all equal. She thinks the Italians are first. I just want you to know that. I want to cut right to the chase here. But at least relative to the Irish. She got very angry with me when I pointed out that in her ancestry there wasn't actually an Irish Catholic. That I'm not allowed to say that again. But anyway, to Linda and Raul and Loretta and Norma, all the folks who are here from the Congress, thank you for being here. And, you know, my staff wrote me some very nice talking points here. And to talk to you about everything from the hemisphere to Cuba to immigration. I'm going to be, Mr. Secretary, how are you? I'm going to be very, very brief because Jill has another person to introduce. Folks, I don't want anybody to be down right now about what's going on in the Republican Party. I mean this sincerely now. I'm being deadly earnest about this. I want you to remember, notwithstanding the fact that there's one guy absolutely denigrating an entire group of people, appealing to the baser side of human nature, working on this notion of xenophobia in a way that hasn't occurred in a long time since the Know Nothing Party back at the end of the 19th century. Folks, the American people are with us. I know it doesn't feel that way, but I'm telling you, the American people agree with us. We're going to take a while to overcome this. Look, you're talking about somebody who's talking about a minority within a minority party within a minority. And the vast majority of the American people are there, because here's what they still believe. The American people are decent. They're basically decent. And, you know, we're about to greet President Xi, who I have spent an awful lot of time with. And he asked me when I was with him last, I've spent at least alone 25 hours with him, because I traveled thousands of miles through China and here with him in both places. And he once asked me at a private dinner, just he and I and two interpreters, he said, how do you define America? And I said, I can define it in one word. He was then Vice President, Mr. Vice President. I mean this from the bottom of my heart. One word, possibilities. What America is all about is possibilities. And whenever you give anyone in this country, regardless of where they've come from, they've struggled to get here or born here, they are looking for a simple proposition. What are my possibilities? If I work, I can do anything, anything at all. And one thing that is shown with the incredible migration that's taken place over four centuries here in the United States of America, give it a chance. Give it a chance. There is not a single person fighting to get here, particularly Latinos and Hispanics, who aren't capable of taking advantage of the possibilities here. What we should be focusing on, in my humble opinion, is focusing on how to guarantee those possibilities remain. Jill talked about, you know, free community college for 9 million people. Well, guess what? That costs $60 billion. People say, how can you afford it? It's real simple, folks. We can do all this. All we got to do is make sure that 0.08% of the population who are trust fund babies, who are already good people, already very wealthy, don't get what they call stepped up basis, meaning they don't get charged for the gain in what they're left in terms of stocks and bonds and capital gains. You know how much that costs America a year? $11 billion a year. That one single change can pay for 9 million kids and grown-ups having an opportunity. So here's what I want you to focus on, because so many of you I've talked to, and you're just down with what's going on the other side. What made me think of this, I walked out of the house just as Trump was talking on the television. Folks, this will not prevail. This will not prevail. And in the meantime, let's not take our eye off the ball. Let's not take our eye off the ball. Continue to fight. And here's the point I want to make to you, and I'll end with this. You know, the same time the Republican debate is taking up, very shortly, the most popular man in the world is about to come to the United States of America. The single most popular man in the world, not just among we Catholics, but among Muslims, among Protestants, among atheists, among people of all faiths or no faith. Why? What is he appealing to? Why is he so popular? Because he, in different ways, it's said in different nations, whatever you do unto the least of my brethren, you do unto me. That's where people are. That's what they're looking for. I mean, I really believe this. I absolutely believe it, that the vast majority of people are prepared to give somebody a chance, if they get a chance. And that's all this is about. This will pass. The Trump and that stuff you're hearing on the other team, and not just the other, this isn't about Democrat, Republican. It's about a sick message. This message has been tried on America many times before. We always, 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 always overcome it. But in the meantime, focus on, watch the response that Pope Francis gets. Watch the response he gets. Because what's he saying? I've had a chance to meet with him in the Vatican. And as I walked up as representing the head of state, because I was the head of state today, after his inauguration, he stands at the foot of the basilica, in the basilica, the foot of the altar. And in alphabetical order, all the countries line up based on alphabet. The United States is obviously toward the end. I get up, and my sister was with me, a very devout Catholic, and meant a great deal to her, and Jill was so kind to let her come with me. And there was an Irish Monsignor, who had spent time with me when I was with Benedict, which was another experience. Not bad, by the way. It was another experience. No, I really mean it. It was like going back to theology class. We disagreed, but here's the deal. He turned and he said, "Oh, Mr. Vice President, it's good to see you again," because he had just been with me 2 months earlier. And he said, "Your Holiness, you know what the Pope did? This is what we got to do." He put his hand out to me, said, "I know, Mr. Vice President." He pulled me and he said, and I mean this literally, he pulled me and he said, "You are always, always welcome here. Always, always welcome here." That's what we've got to do. Reach out. Reach out to the rest of the world. And say to those people who are struggling, "You are always welcome. You are always welcome here." That's what's made us. That's who we are. That's the core of us. And so, folks, don't be down. This could be a fight, but don't be down. In the meantime, let's focus on the other piece of this. The things that do affect the poor, the things that do affect the disadvantaged, the things that are out of kilter now in our system. And they're out of kilter. They're out of kilter. You're all very successful people. Go back to your old neighborhoods. Look your compatriots in the eye and ask them if they can do what my father did to me when he left me with our grandparents to find better work before he could bring us down. I remember my father sitting in the end of the bed. I was sitting in the bed of my grandfather's room, going to fourth grade. He said, "Joey, it's going to be okay." And he meant it. How many people do you know in your old neighborhoods feel like they can look at their children, unrelated to immigration, and say, "It's going to be okay"? And they really believe it. We got to straighten this out, guys. A lot of you are wealthy. A lot of you are successful. Everybody's got to do their fair share here. We got to straighten this out. So please, don't take your eye off the ball. Don't take your eye off the ball. The first thing is, you're always welcome here. And the second piece is, when you get here, there's going to be a level playing field. We're going to look out for one another. That's what this is about, guys. So keep an eye on the Pope and understand, he is the most popular man in America. He's the most popular man in the world. There's a reason. We will prevail in this. This other piece will pass. And well, I have only one question. Where's Pedro Martinez? Come here, Pedro. I get certain privileges as vice president. I know I'm holding this up to you. Come here, man. Me and my dog want to meet you. Ladies and gentlemen, now he had a great career in Boston, but the 1 year with Philly is what I love.
Thank you so much.
You're one of my heroes, pal.
Thank you.
You're
so
one
much.
Of my heroes. I sat there and said, God, if I can do that. Welcome to our home.
Well, thank
Welcome
you so much. Thank you for having us.
Oh, thank you.
All
man.
Latinos, we appreciate you.
Thank you. All right. Sorry, guys. Ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.
Okay.